The human body is pretty amazing. It's made up of hundreds of parts, each one with an important purpose. But there are some parts which may not have an obvious purpose. For instance, why do men have nipples? There's almost always a reason behind these weird parts of human anatomy. This list is full of weird human body parts and the reasons why we have them. Some of these are leftovers, so to speak, from when we used to live in different environments or from when we were developing in utero. Some of these organs have multiple theories about their actual purpose, and some have been figured out for years. What are the reasons for weird human body parts? Uvula. Nobody pays much attention to that dangly little thing in the back of the throat, except perhaps some comic animators. Some theories suggest that the uvula, which is fully developed only in humans, helped our ancestors speak or drink while bending over a watering hole for prehistoric refreshment. But its most obvious purpose involves quickly secreting large amounts of saliva. Over a lifetime, the average person produces enough to fill two swimming pools. The uvula may also be associated with snoring. According to an Italian study, people who snored had significantly fewer nerve fibers in their uvula than their non-snoring counterparts. Eyebrows. Though the hairy strips are especially useful for communicating those say what? Moments, their main purpose is to protect our eyes from debris, water, and sun. Eyebrows are also a crucial factor in face recognition. When volunteers in an MIT study were asked to identify photos of 50 famous faces with their eyes digitally removed, they could recognize the individuals 60% of the time. When the faces lacked eyebrows, however, participants could only ID them 46% of the time. In other words, eyebrows are incredibly important for facial recognition. Armpit hair. Armpit hair is one of those nuisances that seems like it can't possibly serve any purpose, but there is one theory as to why we have it. It diffuses the smell in our sweat to help us attract mates. Many studies have suggested that we are attracted to the body odor of people whose immune systems are different from ours. Armpit hair is a way of advertising our smell. Eyelashes. Eyelashes, similar to eyebrows, prevent dirt and debris from getting in your eyes. They also help to keep your eyes moist by sending the signal that your eyes need to be closed, say, if it's windy. Ear muscles. Your three auricular muscles are associated with your outer ear. These body parts would have helped evolutionary ancestors pivot their ears like a cat does, but they don't serve much purpose to modern humans other than a party trick. Only about 10 to 20% of people are able to engage those muscles to wiggle their ears. Men's nipples. Men have nipples because all fetuses start out with the ability to develop into a male or a female, so every fetus forms nipples. About 2 months into pregnancy, a fetus with an XY chromosome pair gets a flood of testosterone and starts developing male genitalia. Men's nipples are left over from before they turned into males. Fingernails. Fingernails are flattened versions of claws, which developed because primates evolved broad fingertips. Claws are good for getting a grip while climbing a large tree, but our broad fingertips and fingernails allowed us to more easily grasp small branches, fruits, and vegetables, and use tools. Appendix. The appendix, a 3.5-inch long tube extending from the large intestine, seems to be more of a pest than have a purpose. When inflamed, such as from injury or infection, it can eventually burst and fatally spill infectious materials into the rest of the body. The inflammation, called appendicitis, is most common in children. It affects 80,000 per year in the United States. When the appendix is removed, it causes no noticeable effects on the body. However, recent Duke University Medical School research suggests that the appendix houses good bacteria, information that may be useful in rural areas or less developed countries. In modern industrialized societies, if someone's good flora dies, it can more easily be replenished from others, researchers say. Tonsils. If you've ever inspected a sore throat, you've likely noticed a spongy, almond-shaped tissue toward the back of the mouth, looking slightly swollen, red, or laden with white spots. As part of the lymphatic system, tonsils defend the body from infections that enter through the nose and mouth. But they can also become infected themselves when overloaded with bacteria or viruses. Since they're just one component of the body's powerful defenses, tonsils can be removed if they contribute to chronic sickness or breathing problems. However, today's doctors are more conservative when recommending surgery to control infection. About 500,000 procedures are performed annually today in the United States, compared to more than 1 million per year in the 1970s. And even with today's technologies, there are still mysteries about the human body that no one has figured out yet. Fingerprints. These little grooves on our hands on the bottoms of our feet may help us to get a better grip on surfaces. They could also enhance our sense of touch by picking up on subtle differences in texture or vibrations. Nose hair. Is there any real purpose to nose hair than making aging with grace harder than it should be? Sort of, yeah. Nasal hair functions like an all-natural air filter, straining out the nasty stuff in the air we breathe. They trap bacteria, dirt, and viruses among other pests, until we breathe or sneeze them out. So, if you want to get rid of them, trim, don't pluck. Those guys are essential. I hope you liked the video. If you liked this video, then give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.